Tina McDonald, part of Spellbinders design team. In today's tutorial, we're going to be focusing on the wooden fence, as well as incorporating lots of fun other dies, both new and old. I'm going to teach you some different things that you can do with your dies, and we're going to use them to create this fun scrapbook page. Let's get started. Let's begin by assembling the wooden fence. This set comes with four dies, as you see here. And we're going to die cut those just onto some white cardstock. We're also going to die cut this floral burst piece at the same time. So place these with the cutting side up on your base plate, covered by your cardstock, and then place your cutting plate over top. Now we can go ahead and run it through the grand caliber machine. To emboss, remove the cutting plate and replace it with the tan embossing mat and the pink embossing plate, and run it through the grand caliber one more time. I'd recommend using the tool-in-one to help remove the paper from your die templates. To add the coloring to my wood pieces, I'm going to use a foam dauber and some ink in a vintage sepia color. This will help to highlight those high and low areas. I'm also going to take a dual tip marker and I'm using the fine end to highlight some of those grooved pieces. To make the assembling of our fence a little bit easier, I'm going to assemble it onto my craft mat. So I'm going to use an adhesive runner here and adhere the base, which is these two long pieces. I'm going to adhere them to my craft mat. Now using a liquid glue and some form of applicator, I'm just using a Q-tip here, but I'm going to add a little bit of adhesive to the back of these and I'm going to randomly place them across the bars and the base of my fence to create a real fun random design and pattern here. This is so much fun because you can extend this to do a 12-inch strip so that it would extend the entire way across a scrapbook page, or you can trim it off to make smaller pieces as I will be doing in my page. Once your fence is assembled, let the liquid glue dry for just a moment and then you'll be able to peel up your fence in one piece and it's ready to be used on your project. I wanted to add some non-dimensional flowers to my page, so I'm using this floral burst and I'm using my Memento dual tip markers just to randomly color a little bit of coloring throughout these images. I've die cut it twice and I'm going to just use different colors to add some shading and just a little bit of random coloring on here. Once I have these colored in, I'm going to trim the bottom portion off. As you'll see, I'm not coloring it. And that way it's going to be a little bit easier to just add these flowers in through my fence over top and around. But before trimming them, I gave them a spritz of this ink potion number 9, which will help the colors to blend just a little bit. To add some accenting to our scrapbook page, we're going to be using these dies and we'll die cut those now. Place a piece of white cardstock over top of the fancy lattice die. I've nested together several of the dies from the standard circle, small and large, to give 1/8 increments there, so I'll get nice little rings. I'm going to place a piece of black cardstock over top of that, and another piece of black cardstock over the chevron border. Now cover these with the cutting plate and go ahead and run them through the grand caliber machine. As we did previously, the tool-in-one is a great help for removing these papers from these templates. Those small pieces are what we're going to be using in the black, as well as the base here, the actual die cut from this fancy lattice. Now assembling our page, I've just layered some scrapbook papers, as well as the dies that we have already cut out. I'm using along the left-hand side of our photo is where I have our fence, that beautiful wooden fence that we assembled. I've trimmed off those flowers and added a beautiful little garden to the left of the photo as well. I'm using our rings as well as our little arrows from the chevron border. All of these things together make such a fun focal point for our scrapbook page. Thanks so much for joining me for today's tutorial. For more project ideas, be sure that you're following the Spellbinders Paper Arts YouTube channel. Leave any questions or comments in the space provided below and we'll be sure to get back to you. Thanks again for watching and have a great day.